Shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we come to your presence, and this afternoon, our God, we pray that you would hear and answer our prayer. Lord, we praise thee for your greatness. We praise thee for your power. We praise thee, God, for your might and your mercy that you have demonstrated to us in your word and your work of redemption. Oh Lord, at this moment, Lord, we come before you and we ask for forgiveness for every sin that we have done, which is not in accord with your holy character. Oh God, we pray for your cleansing. Oh God, at this moment also, we bring to your presence our brethren who are dealing with medical issues. And at this moment, Lord, we pray for our pastor, for his speedy recovery from the operation. And oh Lord, I pray that he would get stronger, that his wounds would heal fast. We thank you, God, for giving him strength to be able to walk. I pray, God, that you would keep him, maintain his balance as he would walk, so that he would get stronger, oh God, and be able to exercise. Lord, I pray for our members who have gone through serious medical issues, those that are in need of operation. I pray, oh God, that you would touch them, oh God, with your healing hand. And other members who might be dealing with COVID, I pray, oh God, that you would touch them, oh God, with your healing hand. If there would be any of our members who are going through those things, I pray, oh God, we praise you, oh God, for those whom you have healed from this disease, and those who have shared their prayer request from us. I pray, oh God, that you would continually heal them. And thank you, oh God, that they have expressed their thanks and also their trust in your power, oh God. And at this moment, Lord, I pray that your Holy Spirit would work in every hearts and minds as we would hear the preaching of your word. And I pray, oh Lord, that you would bless this service. And in Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Hello everyone, welcome you to Baptist Bible Church, our evening service. Let's open our hymnals to page 40, Trust and Obey.
In order for a person to be saved, he needs to put his faith in Christ. When he received Christ and got saved, that is the beginning of his Christian life. But Christians are tend to be confused and even swayed by the God small letter g, of this world through his false philosophies. And Satan, our enemy, will do anything to take his focus away from God, and it is his primary concern. The Bible mentioned two kinds of person in this world, the Son of God and the Son of Devil. If you are the Son of Devil, Satan doesn't care about you. However, if you are the Son of God, expect that the devil will do anything to take your focus away from God. The book of Colossians tells us that because we have received Christ, we have strength to follow him and deny false philosophies. The title of my message today is The Strength of Receiving Christ. Please turn our Bible to Colossians 2 verses 6 to 15. Colossians 2 verses 6 to 15. We will focus on verse 6 to 10, but we will read until 15. Verse 6. As ye have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him, rooted and built up in him, and established in the faith as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophies and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. And ye are complete in him, which is in the head of all principality and power, in whom also ye are circumcised with a circumcision made without hand, in putting off the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ, buried with him in baptism. Therein also ye are risen with him through the faith of the operation of God, who hath raised him from the dead. And you being dead in your sins and the uncircumcisions of your flesh, hath he quickened together with him, having forgiven by all trespasses, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was written against us, and which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing to his cross, and having spoiled principalities and power, and made a show of them, openly triumphing over them in it. Let's go to the Lord and pray. Dear God, Heavenly Father, thank you once again for this day, for the opportunity to share your word to your people, oh God. I pray that your message for today is a blessing to the listener, oh God. I also pray the forgiveness for my sins, oh God. I also thank you, oh God, for your grace and your mercies abound, and for the forgiveness of our sins through your Son, Jesus Christ. In Christ's name we pray, amen. The epistle to the Colossians was written explicitly to defeat the false philosophies, a heresy or maling katuruan, and these heresies had arisen in the Church of Colossae, which endangered the existence of the church, and the letter of Paul is his response. According to studies, walking is one of the best way to improve one's health, but when we talk about walking with Christ, we talk about imitating him, abiding in him, and leaning on him. As verse 6 says, as ye have therefore received Christ Jesus the Lord, so walk ye in him. That what means to walk in Christ is to walk in his presence. Now, the question is, what enable us to walk in him? In verse 7, the first word we can see here is the word rooted, because we are rooted in Him. Rooted, it is a Christ who caused us to be planted in Him, because our faith comes from Him, and the process already happened, and it suggests that the effect happens in the present. We are planted in a good ground already, and the first cause happened, and we are able to walk in Him because we are already attached to His perfect nourishment of Christ Jesus Himself. The second word we can see here is in verse 7 is built up in Him, because we are built up in Him. This suggests an ongoing process. Ongoing process of what? Ongoing process of God's continuous working in us. We are able to walk in Him because it is Him who's working. Just submit ourselves to God, and we will receive the strength to follow Him. The third word, or the third phrase we can see in this, in verse 7, is established in the faith, because we are established by Him. Established tells us to make secure or sure in the faith. But how? As we have been taught, we are able to walk in Him because of the continuous teaching that makes us more and more stable in the faith by God's grace through the Holy Spirit who is in us. Every teaching from His Word help us to be more firm in the faith, so that we are not easily swayed, or we're not easily persuaded by the world's philosophies and heresies are happening right now. So, as we can see, we will hear a lot of false teachings, false doctrines right now in our country, even in the whole world. But so, if we are always, if we are established in Christ, we cannot sway to that teaching. As we are being taught, we get to know more the person of Jesus Christ, and we believe, which enable us to be stronger in the faith. We can also walk with Him by being thankful. The last phrase in this verse, in verse 7, is abounding therein with thanksgiving. I will read again the verse 7. Rooted and built up in Him and established in the faith as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. So the last phrase is by being thankful. Why being thankful enable us to obey Christ? Because it takes our thought to God. If our thoughts are focused on God, not to ourselves, we are after His will and His way. We live in this unsatisfied, selfish, and short-tempered societies, and it shows everywhere its rough joys of the people and even Christians. It takes the focus away from God, that makes them gone astray and lose sight of following God and become weak. In this epistle also tells us that we are complete in Him, or we are complete in Christ, as we practice a gratitude to God. We grow and experience His perfect will for us. However, we're not only thankful, but as appreciation to God, we must be constant or constantly abounding or abounding therein with thanksgiving. If we are constantly thankful, we were on the way to stronger faith in Him. So in verse 8, says here that beware lest any man spoil you through philosophies and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ. We can walk with Him by having warnings. We can see the word beware. This is a warning. Beware. We are able to walk in Him because there's a warning. Every opinion we heard and every man's practices we see should always be compared and scrutinized if it is after Christ. We have a point of reference or warning so that we will not be deceived. In verse 9, for in Him dwelleth all the fullness of Godhead bodily. So we can walk with Him by having a God Himself, fullness of Godhead bodily. Colossians believers face an issue of attacking the deity of Jesus Christ, that God cannot have a body or a flesh, because all for them, all material things are evil, and that is dualism. And that's why Apostle Paul is telling and making them know that in Jesus, the full nature of God dwell. And that's then Christ came on earth, God came. In all aspects, He is God. There's nothing in Jesus' nature that is not God. So, if you believe that the one you receive is completely God, what more can you ask for? As a result, in verse 10, and ye are complete in Him which is in the God, which is the head of all principality and power. A Christian are complete in Him. We did not become God, but His righteousness is in us. We become a partaker of Him, and that is our strength, followed by many benefits and identification in Him for spiritual circumcision to resurrection. Apostle Paul's message is for everyone. The treasures of wisdom and knowledge are stored in Christ. Isn't it amazing that He is the one to be followed, and yet He's also the source of our strength? If you also want to have a genuine strength, why not to come to Him and receive Him as your Lord and Savior? Jesus Christ is the source of true hope. He died for the forgiveness of our sins, and died and rose again on the third day. Now, I want to remind you how blessed you are to have Christ. How blessed you are to receive Him. Yes, there would be forces that will pull us from Christ, like the Colossians church have experienced. But there will always be a reminder from God to strengthen us. People in nature are too forgetful, but we will not easily forget these things. There is one thing that we should never forget. We should never forget that we have received Christ. and He is with us right now. So, be strong because He is our strength. To God be the glory. Let's pray. Dear God, Heavenly Father, thank you once again for this day, O God. Thank you, O God, for reminding us. Thank you, O God, for your salvation that you have given to us through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, continue to give us strength and to strengthen always our faith, O God, in you. Continue to lean on you, to trust in you always, so that whatever happens to us, yeah, we cannot sway with the false philosophies or teachings in this world, O God. So we can always lean on you, O God. We trust in you. We completely give everything to you for all the praises and glory and honor in this day. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.